Hey Popcorn Talkers, Russell right here on the red carpet and world premiere of Annabelle Comes Home. We're gonna find out some exclusives for you and maybe find out why one of the cast members was terrified of this doll. You got anything to say for yourself? Speechless. Stay right here, we'll be right back. So, you play Daniela, and we heard a little something that you were scared of dolls growing up. Is this true?
It's so true.
Okay, why?
I don't know what it is.
Why not? They're so creepy looking. I mean, they literally just, they look so realistic, especially those porcelain ones, man. They look so realistic. They stare at you, you know, and it's the eyes. I just don't want to walk around the room and keep looking back and think that they're going to, like, follow you. But yeah, I had a doll that looked almost, you know, really, really close to Annabelle. She had braids, porcelain skin, she had red hair. I love hate them. They're beautiful, but they're terrifying.
I think needless to say, you'd be terrified in my grandma's house growing up because she had nothing but porcelain dolls.
That was my room as well. I had a cabinet full of porcelain dolls staring at me every night. I would cry.
Did you ever get rid of them, or what was the age that you got rid of them?
When I was allowed to leave the house and be like, if I'm coming back, those things are not going to be in my room. My mom wanted me to, I think, kind of brave it out, realize that, you know, my doll's not haunted, but you never know, apparently. But yeah, so I wasn't able to get rid of them. She's a very loving mom, I swear.
What was the biggest challenge that you faced with this film? Knowing that Annabelle is the doll and growing up with that mindset, and how did you get around it?
I was able to pull from that, you know, like from kind of going back to my childhood fears and just think of things that terrified me. I think one of the biggest challenges was my voice and keeping it from all the screaming, because, you know, you're in this situation of terror. I lost my voice 3 times during the filming process. Great stuff. I screamed with all my heart. I love it, though, because I love anything that's insanely challenging and terrifying. Yeah.
So final question would be, who do you think, because I personally think that you're going to be up for Best Frightened Performance for MTV Movie Awards next year. Who do you think will be your biggest challenge of your castmates? Like, who's going to be the biggest competition against you?
They're seriously, like, in all honesty, they're all so amazing. They're all so amazing at playing terrified as well. We couldn't have been blessed with a better cast. Everyone. I think all of us. There's no one. I hope that we all win. Can we just have a conjoined group scream best? We'll have great screams as well. I was like, bravo. Thank you.
Well, I'm going to give you a pre-congratulations just in case you win, and I'll be there next year to congratulate you when one of you guys gets the trophy.
My doll fear can give me something.
All right, have a good night. Congratulations on the movie.
Thank you so much. It was so nice to meet you.